power to the whole blasted planet if you have to. We can't let those crazies take over the network.
Captain Winborn, Senator Kale said you need backup. What's the situation?
We're getting cut to pieces down here. We're not trained to fight an army of killers. These gangsters are smart, organized, clearly trained off-world. Kill thousands. Might even destroy the Senate Tower.
Now here's the different choices that you get. Sometimes in this little thing in the middle of the wheel, this little blank spot, you'll see either this sort of a white star icon. That means it's a light side answer. But if you see like this red icon, it's a dark side. So that will affect your alignment and how people perceive you. But none of these choices are giving me that. So
Captain, let me handle the criminals.
Yeah, this little thing down in the corner. They came here with that's blood. Affection with my companion.
Slicers to access every network node in the sector. They're trying to take over the automated speeder flight paths. They'll cause thousands of mid-air collisions. It'll rain debris on the Senate Tower like a meteor storm. Not telling how many will die.
These criminals have gone too far. I'm taking them down.
Best news I've heard all day, Master Jedi. Gangsters have armed patrols guarding the network access points. We need to push them back and manually lock down the terminals. Get enough terminals, we might just pull this off. My men will back you up. Good luck in there.
If anybody's watching this video, feel free to comment and tell me. I've been trying to figure this out myself. My character's voice, can I make him do anything? I guess he doesn't actually have any. Yeah. No sound with his emotes. But his voice sounds really familiar. So rewind back there in the video to where he's talking to Captain Winborn here, and just listen to his voice. I swear it sounds like a voice from like a cartoon. Like, I don't know. I was thinking Family Guy or South Park, but. Definitely not one of those. It sounds... Whoa. It's from something, for sure, but I don't know what. What else have we got here? When you reach level 10, you can kind of, train in a secondary class. Like, when I started, I was just a Jedi Knight. That was the name of the class. But at level 10, you were allowed to pick up, like, an advanced secondary class, which, kind of defines your main class a little further. At level 10, the Jedi Guardian, you can either turn it into a Jedi Guardian or a Jedi Sentinel. Now, a Jedi Sentinel is like a DPS focused just attacker. You get two lightsabers and I guess you're just all out balls to the walls crazy. I mean, two lightsabers, come on. But I went with the other choice, Jedi Guardian, which is a tank. The guy doesn't look like a tank yet, but I'm still level 10, so I'm working on maybe trying to make him look like one. And at level 10, you get these skill trees. I know what you're thinking. Talent trees, World of Warcraft. Shut the fuck up. Every MMO has these, just about. It's not exclusive to World of Warcraft. But yeah, I don't know when you gain the points. It's probably every level, I'm guessing. And you can just assign your training points to these as you go along. So I haven't really experimented with this much because this is my highest level character right now. This is a level 10 guy. But I've tried playing a bit with different characters, but I've never gotten past this level yet, really, so. I want to show you guys the intro and how that works. So I'm going to go log out, immediate. We're going to go make a quick character, just go through the character customization really quickly. It's pretty straightforward. It's not as good as in some of the recent MMOs, but it's, that's two factions right there. Republic or Empire. Empire bad guys, Republic good guys. So, I'm just gonna go with a Jedi Knight because I like the setting at the start. Even though the guy I was just using now was a Jedi Knight. So essentially, we're still going to be seeing the same thing, but I don't... For attacks, in anyway. Same thing.
I will face down all darkness in the galaxy.
My main guy's a guy, so let's have fun here and make a girl.
Helping others is both a duty and an honor.
So we've got your body type. Which changes all that good stuff. Your head changes what their head looks like. Scars, I don't really like scars too much on characters. They look kind of tacky, I guess. So I'm not going to use any. I'm going to randomize how my character looks in a second. And when there's one thing that you're satisfied with that you don't want to factor into the whole randomization, you can just click this little lock icon, and that will kind of exempt it from the randomization, so it won't change that setting for the hyper scars, but everything else will change. Complexion, I don't have any preference there. Eye color, patterns and cosmetics changes all these cool things. The patterns on their head tentacles. Headbands and skin color. So let's just randomize this. Well, I'll keep that body type too. We'll keep the face. That looks okay. So let's see what we can get going here. What should we go with? Let's just put in a random name, because I'm not going to keep this character, I'm just showing off the intro. So we're going to hop on. What do you want? What? Now this is, This will really get you in the mood to play this game. When you actually sit down, you make your character, then this comes up. Right here. Yeah! And this is, what comes up here is specific to the class you choose. I chose Jedi Knight. This is telling me about the Jedi Knight, my character. Let's say I really like how they did that. Now there's another quick little loading screen, and then we're off. Now, very quick.
Welcome to Tython, Padawan. Everyone at the temple is looking forward to meeting you.
Now, come on, doesn't this beat just being plopped into a forest with no intro?
Your former masters praise your combat skills. They say you're becoming an expert duelist.
It's easy to excel when you're trained by the best.
The Jedi Council will assign you a new master to oversee your final trials. You'll be tested in ways you can't imagine. But when you leave Tython, you'll know what it means to be a Jedi Knight. More importantly, you'll know yourself.
I'm eager to face these trials. Where do I start?
There's a speeder here that will take you to... Hang on. I'm getting an emergency signal. Flesh Raiders? Armed with blasters? He must be mistaken.
No, he's not.
You could hear the blaster fire. Go help!
Calm down, Padawan. Never rush into a fight before knowing your enemy. Flesh Raiders are a species of hostile natives. They're smart enough to use tools and violent beyond reason. I'm sending every able-bodied Jedi down to the Padawan training grounds right away. Especially you.
Just point the way. I'll handle the rest.
Take the speeder outside to the training grounds, push back the Flesh Raiders, and find out if they're really using advanced weapons. Go. I'll catch up with you after I alert the Jedi Council. May the Force be with you.
Okay. So, oh, I don't have to change my controls or anything. So I'm just gonna head on down to where you do your first... Oh, yes I do. I don't like how left and right will just make your character turn. So I'm gonna have to fix that. Into the controls. Key bindings. Movement. Okay. Much better. Okay. So now we're off. So this is a bit of Tython right here, the starting area. It looks better in a second. I just gotta get off this structure.
Greetings. You are cleared for the following travel routes.
Really impressive production values in this game. Okay, so come on down here and talk to this dude. Other players are here talking to him as well.